Welcome to Spikes and Heels, the fitness show for badass women. My name's Bangs.
I am a fashion, lifestyle and fitness blogger. I started my blog Spikes and Heels for women who like to train hard.
My name is Jeanette Kwarchi. I am a 100 meter sprinter who has competed at the 2008 Summer Olympic Games in Beijing. On this show, we're going to teach you how to make sure you're committed to your program but looking brilliant whilst doing it.
Hello and welcome to Spikes and Heels.
Today we're going to be reviewing the squat exercise.
In Street Athletes, we'll be speaking to Muay Thai fighter Samantha McHarg.
We'll also be reviewing the Bosu ball and pocket yoga app.
And for Spike Style, we'll be speaking to the designers at Rapha about how they make stylish cycling wear.
On today's Fitbit, we're going to be exploring the squat exercise. Now, we all love a bit of squat because we know it firms up and tones up our booty area. So, I'm going to take you through four variations of different squat exercises, all ranging in terms of ability. The first variation is your standard squat. Have a chair behind you, start with your hands on your hips, and have your feet shoulder width apart. And from that position, squat down to the chair and come back up. Easy. You could do at least 15 to 20, even 30 of those. And I'd recommend about 3 sets. When you start to feel that you need a bit more of a challenge, I recommend that you move then to a single leg squat. Now, this can be quite difficult, so I would suggest having something on the bottom of your heel to give you a bit of leverage. Again, with your hands on hips, you go down and up on one leg, as low as you can go, and come back up. Now, this is a very challenging exercise, and we do recommend that you watch your knees. If you feel any pain in your knee area at all, we ask you to seek a physician. The next part of the squat we learn is the sumo squat. Now, this is where you get really good depth. You stand with your feet more than shoulder width apart, quite wide, and have your feet turned out. With your hands on your hips, you go up and down in the squat position and you get really low. Now, this targets and firms up the deeper parts of the gluteal muscles, and it's really, really good. And the last part of the squat, again, nice and explosive, is called the jump squat. So, have both of your feet, again, hip width apart, hands on hips, and from the floor to the top, I'd like a nice big pop. So you go up and down, I'd recommend 10 of those, 3 sets. A really nice and explosive exercise and a great way to progress your squat.
Today on Street Athletes, we're talking to Sam McHarg, a Muay Thai fighter from London.
Fate.
I'm Samantha and I'm from London and I am a Muay Thai fighter. I train quite often actually. I end up training twice a day for 6 days a week and I have one rest day. I do Muay Thai 5 times a week. We have a fighters group on Mondays and Wednesdays. At the moment, we are 1 week out of fight, so we have been doing 5 3-minute rounds, 10 kicks in the middle, 10 kicks at the end each leg, and then 10 press-ups, which is also followed on by clinch sessions and some technique work. So I do 3 times a week a weights training session for different parts of my body, whether that's a glutes or upper body session and an Olympic lift session. My fitness schedule has actually made me more scheduled in my work life. I get up, I train, I go into work, I do a full working day, I train, I make sure I'm eating well, and it's actually resulted in having a profitable business in 2 years, which is a massive lifestyle change from how I used to be.
One, two, cha. One, two, push, hook,
because you're so engrossed in training, your training schedule, you don't really think about this is actually going to result in me stepping into a ring. You're just kind of focused on what your trainer's telling you to do, what you're getting wrong, what techniques you need to work on. And then for me, it kind of hits the day that I'm fighting and I'm like, all this nervous anticipation of actually getting into a ring and having to hit somebody in the face. And I love it, I love it. I love the adrenaline rush and I love the endorphins I get from a hard session. I love when I've learned something new and I've been able to implement that into the sparring session. So now it's just about learning more and I've absolutely become addicted to the sport of Thai boxing and also of everything that involves it, all of the other work that I do, whether that is a cardio or resistance. I love seeing the improvements in myself. And so that's why I want to keep on bettering myself.
Black hearts in effigy. We sing the song that was leaving. All dressed in black and bones. Shocks up the blood that I'm bleeding. I know there's something wrong.
On today's show, we're going to be reviewing the Bosu ball. It is a mean machine, a very useful machine as well. Now, one thing you have to remember, and we have to be quite clear on, the Bosu ball is branded and quite expensive, but you do get your value for money with different exercises that you can do. If you're trying to rehab or you've got a sore knee or a sore ankle, this is a great way of rehabbing back to full fitness. And you can also have a bit of fun with the ball and use other bits of equipment to kind of get a great workout all over. So you can squat on it, you can jump on it, you can bounce on it, you can do whatever you need to. Press ups, sit ups, it's a great way of adding a new dimension to your workout. So I remember using this mean machine actually when I was coming back from my first injury. It was something that we used for my ankles and for my knees to try and build up the strength and give me something called proprioception or body awareness. It really helps. And things you can do blindfolded on it just so you kind of understand how your body's working and strengthen up the muscles around it as well.
So Bangs, how did you find working with the Bosu ball?
Love a bit of the Bosu. It's slightly large and perhaps a bit cumbersome in terms of home workout equipment, but definitely in terms of the variety of exercises you can do on it and the benefits I think that you would get from that, I really enjoyed it.
Okay, you know, it's quite expensive though. Do you think it's value for money?
Well, yeah, I mean it does, the actual branded Bosu comes with a DVD workout and resistance band. So in terms of a package, okay, but like you say, it is a bit pricey when it's £100 to £150. But on Amazon, you can find what's called a wobble board for about £20, which does basically the same thing, but without the DVD and the resistance.
So if you had to give it a mark out of 10, what would you give it?
For effectiveness, I would say probably about an 8, but in terms of storage, I think you need a fairly large house to be able to store this somewhere effectively. But I'd say it's a decent workout, probably about 7 or 8.
Okay, 7 or 8 out of 10 for the Bosu ball.
On today's apps and stats, we're going to be looking at a yoga app called Pocket Yoga. I really think this is a great app because a lot of times yoga classes can be a bit pricey, or if you just don't have time to get to them, this app gives you a few different variations of things you can do. It's really easy and simple to follow along with. So, Pocket Yoga focuses mainly on the vinyasa flow style of yoga, which focuses the energy of mind, body and spirit coming together and making you all kind of zen out, which is lovely. So it has three different styles of workout that you can do within this. The first one being the ocean workout, which is more cardio. So it's a bit quicker in terms of yoga workout, really keeps it flowing pretty quickly, and you will find that you get a little out of breath with the way that this repetition goes, but that's a really good style of workout. And again, it does a 30-minute style workout for you here with a voice that talks you through all of the maneuvers that you need to be doing. And there's a digital animation of a woman who does it along with you, which is lovely. The second workout included in the Pocket Yoga app is Desert, which focuses specifically on flexibility and detox. So this one's gonna be slightly slower in comparison to the initial ocean workout, which was focusing more on high intensity interval training. This one is going to be slower and really focusing on digging into your flexibility. So if that's an area that you want to focus on, this is really good. And it's more really about unwinding the body and the mind and just focusing on getting that flexibility in. And again, it has an animation that you can follow along with and a voice that talks you through each part of the exercise. The third workout you can do with the Pocket Yoga app is called Mountain. Now this one specifically focuses on power. So if you see people doing all those crazy yoga moves with the headstands and all of those elaborate poses and you really want to do it, this is the part of the app you want to focus on. Really focuses on power, upper body strength, and holding in those positions. So it's really working towards it, holding each pose for longer and longer. And again, talks you through every single part of the movement and has a little person that you can follow along with, which is nice. Today on Spike Style, we're here at Rapha to talk to Graham Rayburn, the lead designer, about the challenges of designing performance wear and how to look good while you're cycling.
What sets Rapha apart from our competitors? I think that the testing and fitting process is it's so thorough. It's absolutely crucial to what I do is to be riding and using and connecting with the product, not just personally, but with customers, with team riders. The fabric has to be extremely breathable, but very protective at the same time against different elements. It's got to have fantastic stretch on it to encapsulate the number of different positions a rider might be in, both on bike when you're sort of crouched over and sitting up and off the bike. It takes a hell of a beating from sweat, sunlight, salt spray off the road. So the clothing has to be adaptable, it has to look good, but it also has to have function as well, and striking the balance in aesthetics there is absolutely key to what we do.
Food processors are great.
This summer I'm going to be riding the Étape du Tour, which is a 130 kilometer leg of the Tour de France through the French Alps. I'm going to be tracking my training journey with you guys throughout the series, and you can follow me doing a little video diary.
Hi there. So as of today, the Étape is 81 days away, so I thought I'd just give you a quick update about how training is going. I've been training really hard for the past 3 months. I train pretty much every day. I get one day off a week. Some days I do double days of training, so I'm just really feeling quite drained and tired physically. You know, I want to know that I have trained hard enough and put in everything I can put into it, so that I've trained as hard as I can train. So on the day, I can't have any regrets. You know I've done everything I need to do to get through the race. Just trying to remain positive, do what I need to do, get these training sessions done, and just keep on. 81 days. What's 81 days in the grand total of my life? You know, like how much can I achieve in 81 days? So got to set myself that challenge now and stay focused.
So that's it for this episode.
Massive thank you to Samantha McHarg, the Muay Thai fighter, and of course, the good people at Rapha.
And thank you to Fitness First for their facilities. We hope you enjoyed the show, and we'll see you next time.